years old and are only half grown. Right now, AMAC weighs just over 500 kilograms or over 1,000 pounds. They're expected to get up to about 1,000 kilos in the next few years. And in fact, these sea lions are the largest sea lion species in the world. Now, that is one great way to tell them apart from the other sea lions we have here in BC, as we have two species of sea lions found off the British Columbia coast. We have the Stellar Sea Lions, who you can see joining us here today, but we also have the California Sea Lions. So you might be wondering, well, if there's two species, they look kind of similar, how can we tell them apart? And in fact, if you heard AMAC at the back there, he was giving a great demonstration of one way we can differentiate the two species. But let's have a bit of fun here today. How about we all practice our very best sea lion impressions? So on the count of three, I want to hear a bunch of sea lions out in the audience today. Ready? One, two, three. Oh. All right. Well, we have Kenai making up for that today. Kenai here is demonstrating the wonderful sound of a stellar sea lion. They make that low, guttural, growl kind of sound, whereas the California sea lions, they make more of that maybe well-known ar-ar barking sound that a lot of us associate with sea lions. So that is one way that we can tell them apart. We can also tell that these sea lions here are a bit lighter in color compared to sitters that go over on the other side there, and they have a nice rounded face, whereas Californians have more of a pointed head for the males and more of a pointed snout as well. So that is a great way to tell them apart. But these animals are very large, and as I mentioned, they're only going to continue growing larger. So it does take a very strong relationship to work with these animals. And to hear about why we're training here today and about what it's like building that relationship, I'm going to hand you over to Trainer Cesar.
Thank you so much. Now, how do you think we make friends with sea lions?
Give them fish.
Fish? Yes. Okay, we give them fish every day. So every day, they're eating around 40 pounds of fish. Ooh. Each of them. Okay, that's 20 kilos. And we use the fish to train them. At the end of the day, they always eat their fish. That means we have to be very patient, and we have to know how to use the fish in a way that has to be smart, okay, in a way that we communicate. Because Kenai over here, he doesn't understand my English. Okay, he doesn't also understand my Spanish. No idea about what I say in Spanish. So how do you think, good boy, come here. How do you think that he knows what I say? Hand signals? Yes, okay, but there is a way in between, because he doesn't know anything until I say what that means. Okay? So we do something that is called positive reinforcement. That means anytime Kenai does something that I want, I give him a fish. Okay? So now you saw I was pointing to the island. Now obviously he really knows what I mean. But if he didn't know, then I'm gonna point, and anytime he goes close to the island, I'm gonna give him a fish. Okay, so eventually they understand that going that direction is really good. Why is this important? Because we need to make sure that they are healthy. One, okay? How do we know they are healthy? We ask them how they feel today, yeah? How you feeling? He doesn't know. Kenai, hey, how you feeling today? Nothing, okay? That's what we normally get. But if we train them, then we can do things like this. Kenai, open your mouth, please. No, your mouth. There you go. Good boy. He can also show me his flipper. There you go. So we make sure it's good. And the other flipper. Why not, Kenai? He's looking. There's people looking at me over here. Very good. Good boy. So that could be the husbandry. Okay, we make sure they are healthy. We check their bodies, their mouth, their eyes, anything to make sure that they are good. And we also need to make sure that they are having fun as well as we are. Okay, so then we train their fun behavior. Like waving, you start sticking the tongue out, and he also knows how to break dance. There you go. And otherwise, he likes to show off. Very good. And this is very important, like I said, so with that, I'm going back to you. you.
Thanks, Cesar. So that's a few reasons why we train, and it gives us a lot of fun behavior to see. But that's only a couple reasons why we train here at the Vancouver Aquarium. The third reason why we train is for research. Southern sea lions have quite a far range. In fact, they can be found as far south as California, all the way through the US coast, BC's coast, and even into Alaska and over to Russia. And it was in the northern part of that range that it was noticed that Southern sea lions had about an 80% population decline over only 30 years. That's a staggering decline. And no one knew what was going on with these animals or where they were disappearing to. So by having animals who were comfortable working with trainers and able to voluntarily participate in research, we were able to learn more about their species and protect their counterparts out there in the oceans. And one of the first areas they started looking at was metabolics, which essentially is a fancy word for how much energy does it take a sea lion to be a sea lion. But just for a reminder for everyone today, we do need to be keeping this boardwalk area clear, especially over on the side here, so the trainers can work with the animals safely. But so with that, looking at how much energy they use, how do we do that? Well, you might have seen some of your favorite professional athletes running on a treadmill hooked up to a machine. And that machine is analyzing their carbon dioxide and oxygen outputs. But we did a similar thing with our sea lions. We train them to be comfortable going into a metabolic dome during rest as well as after activity. And that gave us information on how much energy these animals need to survive. And from there, once we know how much energy they needed, well, the next question is, are they meeting those energy requirements? And as it turned out, when they started looking into that northern population that was declining, they were eating a lot of low-quality seafood. So similar to us, I'm sure we all had breakfast and lunch today, but whether or not it was healthy and an energizing meal is another question. So as it turned out, they would be similar to us eating a lot of popcorn and celery. You might feel full, but they weren't getting the energy requirements they needed. This was especially important for the females with their pups. So rather than having a pup every year, as they do in a healthy population such as off the BC coast, they're having pups about every 3 to 6 years. So that seems to be the main reason why that population decline was occurring. But of course, the more we work with these animals, the more we learn. We don't really know. And it's important to continually work with them to learn more about their species and continue to protect their counterparts out there in the ocean. In fact, there's estimated to be at least 400 sea lions off the BC coast alone who are in need of our help. It's currently estimated that those sea lions, at least 400, are entangled in marine debris. But we see with AMAC and Kenai here, sea lions are very large animals. So what do we think could be entangling a sea lion out there in the oceans today? Can I hear some guesses from the audience? Shout out what you think could entangle a sea lion. Fish nets. Yeah, that is a great guess. And those can be very dangerous for marine animals. We also have a lot of other things. I have with me today, does anyone recognize this? Maybe from some of those packages you got over the holidays. This is a packing strap, often used for packages, newspapers, other things like that. The rest of it looks pretty harmless. For a curious sea lion, it could be very dangerous and even deadly. We saw with AMAC and Kenai today, they don't have hands like you or I to investigate their surroundings, but they're still pretty curious animals. So they investigate their environment using their mouths. This means they can get a piece of marine debris wrapped around their neck as a young sea lion, and as they grow, that piece of plastic or whatever it is will not grow with them. This can cause severe wounds, which could potentially even be fatal for the animals. So our team worked hard, they developed a method to go out there into our oceans, remotely sedate the sea lion, remove the marine debris, and send the sea lions on their way. It's been a very successful program thus far, and they've already rescued over 20 sea lions since the program started in 2014. It's also very expensive though. So a little perspective on that. One dart to sedate one sea lion costs approximately $300. So it's very expensive, and that's why I want to thank all of you for coming out today, because you have already helped support conservation and research efforts and protecting animals out in our oceans like AMAC and Kenai. The Vancouver Aquarium is a not-for-profit organization. for the rehearsal session as they tend to do every day around this time. And of course, their amazing trainers, who none of this would be possible without. Thank you everyone for coming out today and enjoy the rest of your day. Here's the night keeper, Mariam. As the training session has wrapped up, you can see the sea lions have got a special treat today. In fact, this is an ice treat, so it is just a block of ice with a bit of food coloring to make it a little fun. But there are some fish and squid in there at the bottom, so if they can work their way through, they will get that rewarding treat. But and that's one of the ways that we do positive reinforcement, but it's also kind of like us having a puzzle. So it is a great enrichment item for them. But you're welcome to come up, take pictures, videos, anything you like. But I will like to remind everyone, any objects, including cameras or phones, please keep those over our side of the glass. We don't want you holding anything over because it's not great for your devices, but also not good for our sea lions. If you are looking for more programs today, there will be a 4:30 sea otter feed over at our sea otter habitat, which is towards the main building, staying outside and right. But once again, my name is Brittany. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer those for you. Otherwise,